boys and girls. Like, I thought Rue was pretty cheeky and badly behaved, and then we brought out the Christmas decorations and he's got even naughtier, haven't you? Yeah, he just has far too much fun. You see these little Santas over here? Loves those. See this Christmas tree? Loves that. All the stockings, you like hiding in that, don't you? All the snowman toys you think are real snowmen, you start trying to throw snowballs. It's crazy. It is crazy, boys and girls. He's a rascal. But it is also our favourite time of year, isn't it? And we do love getting in the festive spirit, don't we? Yep. I know. Rue is a wee bit sad because I'm in my Christmas jumper today, and I know that some of you, if you're wearing Stone Primary School or in your Christmas jumpers today, and I forgot to get Rue a Christmas jumper. I'm sorry. Your blue one is lovely, but we really should get you a Christmas one, shouldn't we? Maybe next week we'll try and get you a Christmas jumper, will we? Yeah. Maybe we Santa hat as well. Yeah, that would be good. And then you could play hide and seek and I wouldn't recognise you within all the Christmas decorations. Maybe we could do a game for the boys and girls like that, could we? Sounds good to me. Well, we'll get you a Christmas jumper for next week. Boys and girls, I hope you had a good, fun day at school if you were in your Christmas jumper today. It's really great time of year, isn't it? Yeah. Well, Rue and I have been chatting about keeping promises. So we have. And we've been thinking a lot about this the past few weeks, haven't we? Rue's not really very good at sticking to promises. He always says to me, I promise I'll never do it again. And quite often he does do something naughty again. Or he maybe says, I promise to tidy my room. What do you think? Do you think it happens? But then sometimes I make promises to him that I don't really keep either. Like I might say, I promise we'll go to the shop and get a treat. And sometimes I don't stick to my promise. Or I might say, I promise we'll go to the play park after school. But then like it's raining and it just doesn't always happen. Sure it doesn't. No. But here's the thing that we've been trying to learn about promises, all right? Is that a promise is something that you have to wait for, okay? Because otherwise, there would be no point in making the promise, okay? So if I said to Rue, let's go to the shop, well, that's definitely happening. So I don't have to make a promise about that. Or let's say I owed you some money, okay? I could just give it to you there and then I don't have to make a promise that I'll pay you back. But if I don't have it now, then I have to make a promise and say, I promise I'll give it to you maybe next week or tomorrow, okay? And you would have to wait for me to make my promise come true, okay? If I say to Rue, go and tidy your room, and he goes, okay, and goes and tidies it, he doesn't have to make me a promise. But if he says, I promise I'll do it before the end of the week, then I need to wait to the end of the week to make sure he has done it, to make sure that he has done what he promised, all right? And I guess, boys and girls, that's exactly what all the people in the Old Testament had to do. God had made a promise to them right from when Adam and Eve were kicked out of the garden. God said, I promise I'll find a way to get rid of your sin so that you can come back in. Isn't that right? And so all the people in the Old Testament were waiting for God to make his promise come true. So that's what we're thinking about today. promises. And boys and girls, God's promise to send a saviour did come true, didn't it? It came true when baby Jesus was born. And also, boys and girls, God let the people wait for so long. And as they were waiting, they had to be patient and they had to wait and be hopeful of God fulfilling his promise. And in fact, Stuart is going to speak to the mums and dads tonight about how God left the people waiting for 400 years. And then he let his promise come true. It's such a good story. And boys and girls, I found this book here. It's called The Christmas Promise, all right? And who do you think this is? It's baby Jesus. So boys and girls, I'm going to read you this story now about the best promise ever. The one, the promise that God gave us and the promise that God fulfilled. So shall we read this together now? Are you sitting nice and comfy? Ready to listen? The Christmas Promise. A long, long time ago, so long that it's hard to even imagine, God promised a new king. It was that long ago, it was way back with Adam and Eve, like thousands and thousands of years ago. He wasn't any ordinary king, like the ones we see on TV or in books. He would be different. A new king, a rescuing king, a forever king. And do you know what? One precious night, God kept his Christmas promise. Would you like to know how he did it? Would you like to know? Yeah, Rue definitely wants to know. Do you want to know? Yeah, I think so. Let's read on. The Christmas story starts with an angel. Whoosh! He came from God to see Mary. The angel had a special message. Mary, you're going to have a baby. He will be a special baby. God promises that your baby is going to be a king. Not for a little time, but for forever and ever. He will be the forever king. Mary was going to marry Joseph. So God sent another angel. Whoosh! He came to see Joseph. The angel had a special, special message. Mary is going to have a very special baby, the angel said to Joseph. Her baby is going to be king and will rescue his people. He will be a rescuing king. God had promised that his new king would be born in a little city called Bethlehem. And that's where Mary and Joseph went. Are you trying to find Mary and Joseph on the page? I'm not so sure where they are. Somewhere along this path, I reckon. And they're trying to find a room to stay. But Bethlehem was very busy with lots and lots and lots of people. So, when the baby was born, he had to sleep in a manger instead of a bed. What do you think about that? No, it doesn't really look that comfy. Sure it doesn't. All the other mangers in Bethlehem held food for hungry animals to munch. But this manger held a tiny baby. He was God's special new king. The shepherds in the fields had such a surprise. It was quiet and dark and the sheep were snoozing when whoosh, an angel popped into the sky. Wow, do you see the angel up here? Now the sky was bright and the shepherds were so scared. But the angel had a special message for them. Don't be afraid. I have wonderful good news for you, the angel said. God's chosen king has been born tonight. He is going to rescue his people, just as God promised. He will be the rescuing king. Then lots and lots of other excited angels joined in to celebrate. Wow, look at them all. Isn't that so cool? Imagine seeing that in the sky, boys and girls. The shepherds were really excited. They went rushing to see the new king. And there he was, lying in a manger, just as the angel said. But they weren't the only ones who had heard the good news about the promised new king. Who else, I wonder? Some wise men. Can you see them? Some wise men living far, far away had also been sent a message. It was quiet and dark, and they were watching the stars when whoosh, a new star popped into the sky. The star had a special message. The wise men knew what it meant. What do you think? A very special king has been born, the king for all God's people. This child was the promised new king. So here's the three kings here on their camels, and they go whoosh, right round the path. And what does it say? The wise men were so excited, so they went on a long journey to see the new king. And there he was, just as the star had shown them. Do you think it looks like fun? Jesus is a little bit older by the time the kings got to them, because it took them a long, long time to get there. Do you think that you would like to be playing with Jesus, would you? Yeah, looks like he would be lots of fun to play with. Excellent. And they bowed down whenever they got there. And remember, they brought their gifts with them as well. Everything God promised came true. Isn't that what we were talking about, boys and girls? Everything God promised, right from when he kicked Adam and Eve out of the garden and he promised to give them a rescuer king, someone to make it all better, to take away their sin so that we could be with God again. Everything God promised came true. There are lots and lots of different kings in the world, but God sent the greatest king of all. He sent a new king, a rescuing king, a forever king. Wow. And do you know what this king's name is? His name is, I reckon you can shout it out before I turn the page. What do you think? Rue was just shouting it out there. Did you hear him? Jesus. Jesus. Look, Rue, do you see the pictures of Jesus? Let the boys and girls see. There's baby Jesus. There's Jesus speaking to all the crowds. There's Jesus the carpenter alive, doing some woodwork. There's Jesus dying on the cross, and Jesus in heaven ruling over all of us with God. Isn't that amazing? The Christmas promise. God's promise came true when baby Jesus was born. When Jesus came to be with us when Jesus came to live among us and then die for us. That was God's promise came true. And that's what we want to remember, especially this month, but boys and girls, forever and ever, because that's what our faith is all about. That God's promises came true and he sent us Jesus to live for us and to die for us so that we can live. Do you think we could pray with the boys and girls, and then boys and girls, you can maybe go to bed or enjoy the rest of your day, whatever time you're watching this. Oh, good idea, good idea. Rue loves whenever he's doing a promise to make a pinky promise, where him and I get our pinky fingers and twist them together like this, all right? So just where you're sitting, if you want to do it with the people sitting beside you, you can pinky promise with them, or you can just pinky promise with yourself, all right? But Rue and I are going to pinky promise, and we are going to pray as we have our fingers in our pinky promise, all right? So let's close our eyes, link our fingers together, and let's talk to God. Heavenly Father, I just thank you so much for this Christmas time. I thank you for how we can celebrate and have fun and enjoy all the fun things about Christmas time, even though the world is a little bit abnormal at the minute and all a bit different, God. I thank you that we can still celebrate Christmas because you are our forever King. You don't change. And God, I just thank you so much for fulfilling your promise. God, help us to remember this Christmas time that we are celebrating the promised King. We are celebrating the rescuer King, the new King, the forever King who came to save us. And God, we thank you so much for keeping your promise. And I thank you that because of that promise, we can be with you one day forevermore. What a joy to celebrate that this Christmas time. Help us to do that. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. Pinky promise. Thanks, boys and girls, for listening. And keep thanking God and praising him for sending his Jesus as his promise to us. Boys and girls, thank you so much. And I'll see you again soon. Bye.
Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Vixen and Vixen and all his reindeers pulling on the reins. Bells are ringing, children singing, all is merry and bright. So hang your stockings and say your prayers, cause Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. He's got a bag that's filled with toys for boys and girls again. Hear those sleigh bells jingle, jangle. So jump in bed and cover your head, cause Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Doesn't care if you're rich or poor, he loves you just the same. Santa Claus knows we're all his children, but that's everything life. So fill your hearts with Christmas cheer, cause Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. He'll come around when chimes ring out that it's Christmas morn again. Peace on earth will come to all if we just follow the light. So let's give thanks to the Lord above, cause Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Vixen and Blitzen, all his reindeers pulling on the rain. Bells are ringing, children singing, all is merry and bright. Hang your stockings and say your prayers. Santa Claus comes to